Rose is the king of all flowers, and it is a very pretty flower which is grown in all around the world. Rose flower is praised for its beautiful look and aroma. Rose farming business is the profitable business for farmers. In addition, the business demands a small startup capital to initiate a rose farm. Rose flowers and rose oil are very demanded in the local market as well as in the global market. It places the first position in the international market. For profitable rose farming business, you can require the soil pH in between 6 to 7.5. It is the best pH for getting the high yield. Rose plants are growing well in sandy loam soils with high organic matter and also have a high content of oxygen. If you have a 30 cm long soil, then you must be required approximately 30% of organic matter. The ideal soil for rose flowers should be medium loam having sufficient organic matter, proper drainage and pH of 6.0 to 7.0. The soil should be thoroughly dug or plowed 20 to 30 centimeters deep and kept open to sun for at least 15 days. For rose plant cultivation, after removing the weeds, the field should be replowed and leveled. The land with high water table is not suitable for rose cultivation. Before rose planting, prepare a small pit 30 times 30 centimeters to accommodate the earth wall of a new plant. Though the planting of roses on plains can be done from August to March, but the best time is September-October. Different spacing is recommended for cultivation. Different types of rose used for different purpose. Hybrid tea and floribunda roses for beautification in the gardens are planted at a distance of 75 cm, while polyantha and miniature roses require about 45 cm spacing, and climbers and standards planted about 2 meters apart. Manuring in case of new planting is done at the time of preparation of rose beds or pits, and for the established plants, the normal practice is to add well decomposed FEM 8 to 10 kilograms slash peat just after pruning. For applying NPK through fertilizers, we require a mixture of about 50 grams slash plant or 10 kilograms slash 100 square meter. A mixture of urea, single superphosphate and potassium sulfate in the ratio of 1 to triple and 2 in 3 applications. First at pruning, second at the end of December when the first flush is over, and third at the end of February. The newly planted rows need frequent watering till they establish, and afterwards once or twice a week. You must do weeding and hoeing after every alternate watering. In addition, all roses require pruning in the second year of their planting and subsequent years. After 6 months or so, there is every chance that the soil becomes stony. Therefore, you must loose the soil for efficient irrigation. The removal of leaves is known as defoliation. However, you must do it to induce certain plant species to flower or to reduce transpiration loss during periods of stress. In addition, you can remove the leaves manually or by withholding water. The principal pests of roses are red spider mite, leaf rollers, white fly, thrips, aphid, and nematode. The principal diseases are powdery mildew, downy mildew, botrytis, pruning dieback and black leaf spot. However, the attacks depend on the variety and agroclimatic condition. You will need to prepare with the intensive protection system. You can harvest the flowers with sharp secateur at the tight bud stage when the color is fully developed. In addition, you must keep at least 1 to 2 leaves with the plant after the cutting, because it helps to encourage production of new strong shoots. Furthermore, you must harvest preferably during early morning hours.